God took care of Ruth and Naomi, so I know he'll take care of me and my homie.
Welcome everybody to the J Sadie Variety Show, and praise the Lord. Hello to all. I'm J Sadie Gray, and I'm here with my sister Lenny. She's our DJ. Isn't that right, Lenny?
That's right, Sadie.
Well, winter weather's upon us, and one thing our daddies taught us was to pay attention to our car's fuel level. So we're going to talk about that today. But first, Lenny has a song queued up for us. Here is Jesse Dixon singing, "Fill My Cup, Lord."
Like the woman at the well, I was sinking, but things that could not satisfy. And then I heard the Savior speaking, draw from my way that never shall dry. Fill my cup, Lord. I will fill up, Lord. Come and cleanse this thirsting from my soul. There are millions in the world always craving. They crave pleasures, earthly things of old. That's not us. None can match the wondrous pleasure, the treasures that we find. Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Fill my cup, Lord.
Fill my cup.
I lift
you
up, Lord.
Coming in to fill up, ran over the hose and rang the bell. Lenny and I would help out at the filling station whenever we had extra time, which was about a day a week. We pumped gas some and remembered the drivers most of the time would say, "Fill her up," and we did. We would fill up the old display, we would fill up the pop machines, we would fill up the candy machines, we would fill up the chip machines, we would clean the restrooms and fill up the paper towel dispensers. We also wash cars. We'd do whatever was needed, especially to maintain the work and lobby areas, such as wiping down all the hard surfaces, scrubbing down the bay floors, sweeping and mopping the lobby, for just a few examples. Now, years later, we still pay attention to our car's fuel level, but now we pay attention to our spiritual fuel level as well. We daily get in the Word to keep us filled up on the Word of God. You can do that different ways by just simply reading it or doing a Bible study, doing a daily devotional, listening to the Bible being read, or listening to Christian music, going to church and Sunday school, and even Wednesday night prayer meeting. That's just a few ways to be filled up spiritually and to maintain it by doing daily checks in our lives, like watch what words we say, how we treat people, and that we have forgiven all. We like studying in the book of Ruth, and we see Ruth keeping her spiritual life filled by making the one true God her God, and by following the guidance of the Lord through her mother-in-law, Naomi. So in these rough times, we need to stay spiritually full. And if you're not full, and you need the Spirit of the Lord in you, just pray this prayer with me. Dear Heavenly Father, please forgive me of my sins. I believe Jesus is your Son, and that He died on the cross and rose from the dead. Please fill my life with You, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. So if you truly believe in your heart what you prayed, you're saved. Praise God. Now it'd be good to read your Bible daily because it does help you maintain and grow your faith. Isn't that right, Lenny?
That's right, Sadie.
Well, it's time for another song. Here is the Griffith family singing, Fill Me, Lord.
How do I get from where I am now to where You want me to be? Speak to my heart and help me be still and hear what Your Spirit is saying to me. I've spent so much time seeking my will. I never took the time to find Yours. But now I'm on fire, consumed by desire, and I'm longing like never before. Fill me, Lord, I hunger and I thirst for You. Fill this vessel till it overflows. Pour me out for the purpose You've created me, for Your glory. Fill me, Lord.
we've got one by our favorite poet, Deborah Ann. This one is titled, Fill Me Up, Lord. Fill me up, Lord, till I overflow. With your love, keep my heart aglow. Fill me up, Lord, till I burst inside. With your power, help me to abide. Fill me up, Lord, till I bust all out. With your peace, rid me of my doubt. Fill me up, Lord, till I gush and spew. With your grace, restore and renew. Fill me up, Lord, till I overspill. With your love, let me have my fill. Deborah Ann wrote that poem after she read Matthew 5:6, which states, Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Well, the big hand on the clock is about straight up, so we're about out of time. Isn't that right, Lenny?
That's right, Sadie.
We want to thank you so much for listening, and we have you in our prayers. And if you have a prayer request, just private message us on Facebook at J Sadie Gray, G-R-A-Y, or go over to our website, jsadiegray.com. We're going to leave you now with Reverend Pappy Beaver. Now, Reverend Beaver had a program on WKXV every Saturday morning, and he would preach and he'd sing, and here is one of those songs that he would sing. Here is the gasoline song. And have a blessed week.
Some people are just like an automobile. They run fine when everything's right. When the road is all clear and the weather is fine, and there's plenty of sunshine and light. But often they come to a washout and then get stuck and have to detour. And maybe the brakes in the testing will prove they were never were built to endure. It's plenty of water and plenty of oil and the best gasoline you can find. Have your engine tuned up and look out for your brakes. You'll have some hard places to climb. The top or the tarp or the blowout will come. On a danger curve, keep an eye. But if you let Jesus take a hold of the wheel, he'll make it to heaven on high. Autos are painted and polished so bright, they sell far more than they're worth. And some people who think their perfection will do stop short of the Bible's new birth. Just start up your engines and then you can tell if the thing is hitting on sale. But
on behalf of Lenny and myself, J. Sadie Gray, let's pray that soon the sun will reign. God bless you all in Jesus' name.